It's been 3 years since I graduated from engineering science, and I still remember it like it was yesterday. But even though I'm a successful entrepreneur, astronaut, concert pianist, and tenured professor at Stanford with a supermodel girlfriend and a cornfield sports car I designed myself, I find myself unable to adequately describe the engineering science experience. If only I'd never agreed to give this speech at my old high school. At least I've still got plenty of time before I have to be there. But even with 3 whole hours to write, rehearse, and drive across town, I'm still worried that I won't be able to convey the exhilarating sense of adventure that EnSci filled me with. Ah well, better start at the very beginning. Rule 1. Know your audience. Well, like I said, I still have plenty of time.
James Stewart, Calculus EnSci.
One minute, Mom. I'll be right down.
Even or not, Hubert isn't at home. Please leave a message at the beep. I must be out, or I'd pick up the phone. Where could I be? Believe it or not, I'm not home.
Hey, have you guys started that Civ problem set yet? I heard it's pretty stressful.
No, I mean it requires a lot of tensile strength. No. What I really mean is... My brain's been compressed beyond the capacity of a concrete pillar. I haven't slept in days. Where have all the soldiers gone? I don't even remember.
Calm down, Kenny. None of us have been getting enough sleep. But don't worry, we'll work on that tonight. Now, if only we could find a dog 2.5 times its normal size.
I can't even imagine how much worse this is going to get. I haven't even begun to think about which option I'm going to choose.
This whole program is starting to seem like some sort of cruel game.
This is engineering science. These students enroll, unsure of the difficulties that lie ahead. Unsure of each other. And unsure of their own fates. Yet they must navigate the concrete jungle. Survive the university wilderness. They study. They play. They do whatever it takes to see it through to the end. 372 students. 4 years. One survivor.
Thank you. votes are in. Alfred. Alfred.
Man, they're really trying to cut back on class sizes this year, eh?
Yeah, I heard that if this doesn't work, they're gonna start assigning us the actual grades we get in our exams.
I don't know who this is, but I'm going to assume it's Alfred. Alfred. The division has spoken. Alfred, bring me your mug. As we all know, in this program, coffee represents life. Without coffee, you cannot survive. I'm sorry. You're the 367th person voted out of Edgeside. The rest of you, go home and get some rest.
Bastard!
I don't understand! It's so small and it's in my room!
I'm Roy McNear. You might remember me from such lectures as Killer Robot, Friend or Foe. Or while you weren't sleeping, you were designing a killer robot. Today I'm here to explain how a few simple electronic components, a little bit of ambition, and thirst for human blood can help you create a deadly killer robot. Here's where the potentially life-threatening magic begins. First, combine a killer's instinct with some circuit boards and CMOS transistors. Then you add some wires and LEDs to increase the wow factor. Presto, you've just created your very own homicidal robot.
Well, it's been a fun 4 years plus PUI.
You got that right. Those confusing transition months in first year.
And that second year design project.
And then in third year. And fourth year.
Yeah, not too much happened then.
Right, but the important thing is that engineering science prepared us so well for whatever lies ahead. Particularly if what lies ahead is a long stint in academia, but we made some good friends, and we learned more than most people will have ever forgotten, and now we're finally ready to take our places as the leaders of the future.
And to think that at first I thought engineering science wouldn't be right for me. It's been so easy to meet people with similar interests. I mean, think of all those nights we spent playing video games.
That's it! A game of human Pong! Why didn't I think of this earlier? Well, on second thought, maybe comparisons to antiquated video games aren't what Ensai is really all about. Perhaps it's as I was saying to Angelina and Kenny before graduation. It's friendship and knowledge that are really important, and engineering science prepared me better for life than it did for any graduate school. Yes! That's perfect! And I did it with plenty of time to spare. Oh, crap. That could have been embarrassing. Almost forgot the printout.